Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making peanut butter cup fudge. And we're going to start with some melted margarine. Here I have one stick of margarine that is melted. And to that, I'm going to add some peanut butter. I have 1 1/2 cups of peanut butter. So I need a pretty big spoon to get that out. It's going to be kind of tough. See my little friend sitting here? This is my grandson, Carter Evan Atkins. And he's going to watch me make some peanut butter cup squares, we'll call them. See that come out? Isn't that great? Now don't touch, it might be a little hot. But it's going to taste good, isn't it? So what I need to do now is take this back to the stove and melt this together. So we have a mixture here of one stick of melted margarine, 1 1/2 cups of smooth, creamy peanut butter. We're going to melt that together, and then we're going to come back and add a few more ingredients. So I'm going to go away, and we'll be right back. Now I have my peanut butter and margarine melted together. See how it looks? So I'm going to turn the stove off there and bring this over here. Now this is hot. You can look. And we're going to add a couple of items. I have 1 teaspoon of vanilla, which goes in. That's just pure vanilla extract. Let's get rid of that. And then I have 2 cups of confectioner sugar. So we'll be adding those in and just mixing it all around. Wow, did you see that go out there? So I stir this around. You know the next thing we're gonna do? What do you think?
I don't know.
You don't know? Well, if I don't spill it on the counter too much, we're going to pour it in that pan. So I have to just keep, I think my spoon is too big now. Don't you think it's pretty big? It's way too big. Okay, now that's hot. So if you're gonna touch it, wait just a minute. You think this is gonna look good?
Mm-hmm.
Think it's gonna taste good? Okay, it's almost to the point where I can put it in our pan. The idea here is to get it all to come together and be completely blended. It's going to be a wonderful taste of peanut butter and confectioner's sugar with a little bit of margarine there and vanilla. So now, here's where I'm going to put it in this pan that's been waiting right here.
Wow!
Wow!
Good.
Yeah, well, I'm going to make it look better. We need to spread this out a little bit. You think you might be able to eat some of this after a while?
Uh-huh.
Think it'll be good? I think so, too. So we just try to get to all corners and sides and smooth it down the best we can. You can see it's very tough here, but that's what we want because we're going to cover this with chocolate.
Because, chocolate?
Yeah, remember it's peanut butter cup and it should have some peanut butter flavor on the bottom and then it should have chocolate on the top. So when you get this ready, I don't think we have to do anything with that.
Wow!
Yeah, it's not done. We go over to the stove and I have a double boiler here, and that's where I've been heating my chocolate. Turn that off. Now this is hot.
Whoa!
Can you believe that? So we just pour this and spread it.
Wow!
And that's gonna finish it up. Isn't that gonna be good?
I like chocolate.
Yeah, I know you like chocolate.
I like peanut butter too.
Yeah, everything you're liking a little better as you see it. Mm-hmm. I'm going to put that there for a second and work on this We want this spread on the top, and we want it to look fairly nice, but it's going to melt what's underneath, so we have to move rather quickly. And what I used was about 6 ounces of milk chocolate morsels. And I just heated them in the top of a double boiler to get them like this. And normally I try to make this a little prettier. You can swirl the top. You can get it really nice along the edges if you take more time. But I think this is going to work for us, isn't it?
Wow!
Right on cue.
That's good.
Yeah. So we got to let this cool now. This sits at room temperature. You do not refrigerate it. It will set up, and then we'll cut it into squares, and who's going to eat it?
Me!
Yeah. We'll like it. Carter and I are ready to finish up our peanut butter squares, peanut butter cup squares. They're kind of like Reese's cups, so if you like Reese's cups, you'll love this. What I'm going to do is to cut along the line here. You see I've removed some of this already. It's been about 3 hours that this has been sitting, and actually it should be sitting longer than that in order for this to be firm. So it's not exactly firm, but we can go ahead and remove some, and we're anxious to eat it. So just cut with a knife in the size that you want, and I chose to make this kind of a small size. Then you cut crosswise, making little squares, and it's the ones at the beginning are a little bit hard to remove. That's why I started working on those, and I have brought them out and wow. Put them on a plate like this.
Wow! Those are good.
Yeah. And then what I'll do is take a fork, maybe, and reach under there. And see how nice it comes out? So that goes right there in the middle. And we could do more, but you get the idea of how to serve these up. Do you want to take one? Taste of it and tell me what you think.
I like it.
You like it? Mm-hmm. Well, great. I think my viewers will like it too. Mm-hmm.